Hi everyone, thanks for joining us today. Today we're going to spend some time on MIL-STD-461 CS114 testing, and we'll be using our amplifier research CI00402 test system. We'll be using the TESIC CIP9136A as the injection probe for today's video with our conducted RF test system. We'll go ahead and we'll start with an overview of the test system and the components. Then we'll move on to making the necessary connections. Then we'll go ahead and we'll start up the system and we'll run a calibration at curve number 5 of MIL-STD-461G. Let's go ahead first and let's take a look at some of the different components. Here's the AR CI00402 conducted RF test system, which we'll be using for today's video. This system has a built-in signal generator, spectrum analyzer, as well as a 100-watt RF power amplifier. Most important for today's video, this built-in amplifier provides 100 watts of nominal power from 10 kilohertz to 400 megahertz, allowing for compliant testing to MIL-STD-461 CS114. For additional information about the AR conducted RF test system, check out the system overview we did. I'll put a link in the description below for that, and that's going to walk through a little more details about the system. Here you'll find the TESIC CIP9136A bulk current injection probe, and this probe allows for testing from 4 kilohertz up to 400 megahertz. This probe is currently in the PCJ9201B calibration fixture, and that's how we're going to be using it for today's video as we walk through the setup for the calibration. This probe is a good solution for CS114 as it covers the required frequencies as well as allows for sufficient power to meet the required limits. Let's go ahead now and let's spend some time walking through the setup. For the setup today, we're going to go ahead and we're going to follow the guidance from the amplifier research software for the calibration setup. And you can see that on the screen right now. This diagram is particularly helpful in the setup of the CI00402 conducted RF test system. And you can see we only have two connections we need to make on the system itself. The first one is going to be our RF output, and that's going to go to our injection device, and then to our attenuators, and then finally to the monitor input. You will notice for level 5, we do need both a 10 dB as well as a 20 dB attenuator, and those are going to connect to the monitoring input. Here's the EMCware software from Amplifier Research we'll be using to control our AR conducted RF test system today. Let's go ahead and make sure we have the correct software mode for conducted immunity. We have the right test option for CS114. We have our AR system selected. And now let's go ahead and let's click on equipment. All right, so here's our equipment list manager page. We have our active test system, our CI00402, and then some different equipment internally and externally. For today's video, like we mentioned earlier, we're using our TESIC CIP9136A. And this is where you can go ahead and add or remove different injection devices. And like we mentioned a second ago, we are going to keep it with our TESIC CIP9136A. However, you can see on the right, there is a couple different options there. We have BCI clamp, EM clamp, CDN as well. All right, so let's go ahead and click Save. All right, that should just about wrap up the equipment list manager. Let's go ahead and let's click OK. All right, so now let's go ahead and let's take a look at our test setup. All right, here you're going to find the test setup menu, and you'll see right now we're on the test parameter setup tab. Looking in the upper left-hand corner, you will find our predefined setups button. That's just going to let you load different standards requirements that you can use for testing. You can also modify some different criteria you can see on the screen right now. However, we're not going to do that in today's video. We're just going to keep the default settings. Let's go ahead now and let's take a look at the signal routing tab. All right, so here you'll find a a list of the equipment and our active system. So it's our CI00402. And we have our system test in the upper right corner. We walk through that in another video. So if you're interested in kind of seeing more about the system test, go ahead and check that out. And then finally, we have our EET monitoring tab. For today's video, we're not going to be actually testing anything. However, this is the final tab in the test setup menu. Let's go ahead now and let's save our test setup. And let's go back to the main screen. All right, now let's go ahead and let's run our calibration. All right, here's our calibration menu. And when this calibration does run, you'll see the different data points populate on the display here. Let's go ahead and let's hit start. And here you're going to find our injection device. And as we talked about previously, we are using the CIP9136A. Taking a look just below that, we have our options. We're not going to check the amplifier linearity, and we're not really too worried about modulation right now. So let's go ahead and let's hit next. And then we have some additional information you can enter here. Again, we're really not too concerned with the general information or anything about the EET today. All right, so here is our signal routing setup, or kind of your test setup here. We already walked through that. However, this is just a great resource if you need to double check your setup. All right, so now let's go ahead. And we've already warmed up our amplifier, so let's just hit skip for today. Excellent. So now if you look under the test controls right there, you should see calibration in progress, 0% complete. And let's give this a couple seconds to run here, and we should see that change from 0% to 1 or 2% here shortly. All right, excellent. So now we have 2% complete. Let's go ahead and let's let the calibration run, and then we'll start the video up again. All right, so our calibration just finished. You can see right there by test controls, we have completed, indicated there. And then kind of in our middle box, we have the calibration. You can see it has completed in green. So that should just about wrap up today's video. We began the video by talking a little bit about the amplifier research, CI00402. Conducted RF test system. We walked through some of the connections on the front and the back of the system. Then we went ahead and walked through the setup. And then finally, we went ahead and we ran the calibration for MIL standard 461 CS114 for curve 5. Please keep us in mind if you're ever in need of any rental conducted RF test equipment. And thank you for your time.